The Dog Pound will be barking as EA Sports is pleased to join you from the always raucous Cleveland Browns Stadium in downtown Cleveland, Ohio. Is upon us. It's week 12 of the NFL season, and we're underway on EA Sports. And able to take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line. Going to take this ahead for right around 3 yards, but no more than that. Second down. This defense for the Steelers, they were very solid last week in the victory over Baltimore.
And the big difference in the ball game, their ability to force turnovers, three of them in fact, being able to take the ball away, give it back to their offense, that's something that's emphasized each and every week, and they carried it out.
Now it's Watson. That's out to Chubb, complete. And he'll have it past midfield, almost to the 40 before being taken down. 27 yards there, a first down.
That turned into a very well-orchestrated play right there. Going to work his way out of the backfield to the right, and after he looked it in, he found plenty of space to roam and picked up big yardage.
On first down, they'll run with Chubb, and they'll get him down after a pickup of 8, second and 2. The Browns at 500, sitting at 5-5. They were winners their last time out, so they'll be looking to make it 2 in a row.
And so much about football, partner, comes down to mindset, being in the right frame of mind, and the best way to get in that good frame of mind, winning. So they come in feeling good. They've got the home crowd behind them. I think they're going to be tough to beat in this one.
And he'll get a little over 2, maybe a full 3 down to the 32-yard line. You look at this Steeler defense. They were very solid last week in the victory over Baltimore.
And the big difference in the game, their ability to force turnovers. Multiple, in fact. Being able to take the ball away, give it back to their offense, the big difference in the game.
It was impressive. Now the question, can they duplicate it? And he is going to have a Browns first down as they're able to move the sticks with a gain of 4 on 3rd and inches.
3rd and inches, they just hand it to the big battering ram there. That's football 101, isn't it? That's bread and butter. Turn around, hand it to the big fella, and let him get forward for a first down.
They'll bring a receiver in motion left. He'll get an opportunity with it on the touch pass. And he'll get this one down to about the 27. A tackle by Cole Holcomb.
A nice play design there with the touch pass. Looked good at the start, but bottom line, the defense was ready.
And they did a nice job scouting, didn't they? Not just scouting, but now executing once they saw the play for real after having worked on it all week in practice. They drilled on the play, then they drilled him.
From the gun, here's Watson. Dumps this to his running back, Chubb. And they're going to have themselves another first down as the tackle's made at the Steelers 16. Give them 11 yards that time and a new set of downs.
Well, they'll use him a lot out of the backfield. He had 5 catches a week ago, and he makes another catch here for good yardage.
So the ball down to the 16 here for 1st and 10. Now they return to the ground game. Chubb halted in his tracks by Keanu Benton.
Early down stuff to put this offense in a precarious position. We know that securing the point of attack, especially against the big body guys in the middle of this D, has got to be priority one.
They work now on 2nd and 9. To throw is Watson. To the right side, and he's got more complete. Yeah, the Browns are going to be set up with a 1st and goal coming up as they get him down at the 6-yard line.
Charles, Thursday night game, I think a lot of teams probably say shrink the playbook somewhat. Is that correct?
I think you're right about that, because you just don't have the amount of time that you have in a normal week to put in a full playbook. So, as you said, you shrink the playbook, pick out the plays that work best for you. You know what else you're looking for?
What's that?
Who are the freshest guys coming off the last game to play on a Thursday night? Guys have a little extra pep in their step. You go to them early and often. Got to give credit where it's due. Really nice defense on that play. The pitch and catch was successful, but not any run after it.
2nd and goal from inside the 5. Chubb will get about halfway there as he takes this from the 4 down to the 2. A gain of 2 there on the heels of a 1-yard pickup on 1st. Driven it down the field nicely here on the opening drive, but now it's put up or shut up.
No doubt about it, because to make that type of a drive and ultimately kick a field goal would feel very disappointing. But I'm just wondering, is the head coach thinking, is this 4 down territory? Might he go for it?
They'll give it to Chubb. Yeah, this is going to depend on the spot, but I believe he might be a few inches short. This defense not budging. Back-to-back carries of just 2 yards. This is a long drive offensively. Wouldn't you hate to end this with just 3 points?
Doesn't it feel like during a ball game you have certain narratives going on and there's certain drives that seem to take on just a bit more importance than others?
And he'll get in. He's over for the touchdown. Deshaun Watson, his 11th touchdown of the year. And the Browns' decision to go for it pays off with 6 points. The PAT up and good, but hold on a second. There is a flag. Uh-oh, flag comes out here. This is going to be roughing the kicker.
When you're going back there on the kick block, you've got to go to the right point. That didn't happen. Ran into the kicker. The penalty flag had to come out.
And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. So 1st and 10 now from the 30. They'll start on the ground with Harris. Oh, he's got some breathing room. And this is going to be a Steelers first down as he'll get this up to about the 42. After 1, 7-0 on EA Sports. Steeler football here to begin quarter number 2, as they've got it with a 1st and 10. Running straight ahead, and he'll fight forward on the straight ahead running for just a couple of yards. 2nd down.
Well, any lane that might have been open there was closed pretty quickly, and that was because the defensive front, they won that battle at the point of attack at the line of scrimmage. They used great leverage, held their spot, and stacked him up.
Out of the gun, Fields. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete.
Part of what we're seeing so far is the defense is certainly coordinated. Both levers doing their jobs in tandem. The back helping the front helping the back. The pressure got home on that last play and forced him to try and throw through contact, and short of the sticks.
Fields.
He's caught on the sideline, but he's not going to have a first down. They say he was out of bounds, so a big call there that brings up fourth.
One first down here, and that's all, folks. Good work by this defense to hold things in check and force a punting situation.
On is the punter, Johnston, now as he sends this one away.
It's a 39-yard punt, and good coverage means a loss on the return. And the Browns will take over, first and 10.
The Cleveland offense ready to go. And they are back to 500 on the year, got the win last weekend, and it's one that kept their playoff hopes alive.
And if you do have those hopes, 500 is not where you want to be at this point of the year. Now, we know they battled through some rough patches this season, so it now comes down to how they're going to finish. Not out of it, can't afford any more missteps, though.
So the opening play of the drive goes backwards. Now they'll come up on second and 12. And different running back, same result as they stop him behind the line.
It'll be a loss of a full 3 yards there, and it also brings up third down.
And Cameron Hayward's ability to take on blocks, hold the point of attack, and get upfield serves him very, very well. What a nice play there.
Yeah, he can take on blocks because he's built like a block. Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. And he works it across the 25 before being tackled. Deshaun Watson, so multi-dimensional, able to scramble for the first.
With nowhere to throw it, decided to scramble, and a nice job, CD, got the yardage that he needed.
Yeah, and his teammates are certainly going to appreciate that effort, even if his coaches don't, because they would have wanted him to slide and protect himself. But he chose team game over personal protection.
And the running lane's non-existent in this first half as they'll stop him behind the line.
The running lanes have definitely not been there for him here in the first half, and I don't think it's all been his fault. His offensive line hasn't given him much space. A loss results there.
Now they contend with a second and 12 after the loss. Here's Watson. And he'll find Akins there, complete. So the completion good for just three. And that's going to set up a tough third and 9.
Well, that was an okay hookup there with his tight end, but unfortunately, they didn't get the kind of yards they had hoped for. That's going to bring up third down.
The Browns on third down. They've been okay, 2 for 3 thus far. This is third and 9. Now Watson.
Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
Now, that's a good bounce back after giving up a touchdown on the opening drive. Just one first down permitted and then out. Obviously, no loss of confidence with that defense, and now they get to turn it back to their offense.
And Bohorquez on to punt as he gets it away.
That's taken on the 25. Good blocking there, nearly sprung him. As it is, it'll go as a 19-yard return. And the Steelers will go on offense here, first and 10. The Pittsburgh offense at the line to start their next drive. The crowd may be losing just a little bit of the edge after back-to-back punts.
They want some big plays. They want to see some offense. They want to see somebody break away, whether it's through the air or on the ground. Now it'll be interesting to see where the patience is on both sides. Each head coach, can you hang in there and not try and force something that could put your team in some jeopardy?
Now it's Fields. Oh, he was hit as he threw it there, and that one winds up incomplete.
Well, congratulations to them. They come through defensively with another stop. And let's face it, this secondary, they've gone unchallenged so far in the first half.
Now a second and 10.
Opening carry of the game for Cordarrelle Patterson. And some good tackling there as he stopped up at about the 41. They do get a couple, but they'll be left staring at a third and 8 coming up.
Defensively, we always know that he is tough in run support, and I think the way that he gets there is he understands what an offense is going to do before the ball's even snapped. A great job of scouting prior to the game, then reading, reacting, and taking the right path to the ball carrier.
And he gets this one inside the 15, just a yard or two shy of the 10. Now a first and 10 at the 11. Play action. It's Fields. And now they're inside the 10 as he's brought down at the 9. He'll get 3 yards on the scramble there at second down.
Brandon, once that one broke down, there were only so many options left for him to take. Fortunately, only first down, so smartly got the yardage he could get and didn't worry about trying to turn into a bigger play and end up taking a bigger loss. Here, they hope they can regroup and get something different going here on second down.
Still about 3 yards shy of a first as the 4-yard pickup brings it to third down.
Some of the most unselfish players on any football team, defensive tackles, because we ask them to just eat up blocks and allow other people to make tackles. But when he can make a play himself, as we just saw there, that's a big day.
That'll be tackled about 2 yards shy of the line to gain. A 1-yard pickup leads to fourth down.
Anytime you decide to use your quarterback as a runner, most of the time when you design a play, you're expected to break a little bit bigger than this one, because when you run him on short gains, your risk reward and him taking hits, I'm not sure that's the payoff they were looking for.
They're going to go for it now, fourth and 2. Remember, they can still get the first down at the 1-yard line, though. They're going for it. This is Harris. And he's not going to get the first. I don't even think he made it back to the line of scrimmage. They'll get neither the touchdown nor the first down. And that will force a turnover on downs. The Browns drive about to get started. And with a 7-point lead, they'll likely look to take this to the locker room and not really press the issue. They start on the ground with Nick Chubb. And he'll just push his way forward for a few as the clock will run. Now the Steelers use the first of their 3 timeouts. As the clock will stop with 37 seconds to play in this first half. Second and 7. And they'll send Judy in motion left. And now a fake on the jet sweep and a give to Chubb. Now the Steelers use the second of their 3 timeouts as they'll stop it with a little over 30 seconds to go in the first half of play.
I do know from experience that when you slow down someone's running game, you're now doing the dictating on defense. And guess what? Now you're getting ready to tee off on their quarterback because they have to throw it all the time. But you still have to be alert for the draws and other plays of that nature to make sure you don't get hurt.
Back to throw, Watson. Pass taken in by his big tight end. And he is going to have a Browns first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
A lot of times when you get a manageable third down situation like this, you have to think about your tight end, and he comes through for him, picking up the first down.
Watson. And he's got the hook up to Moore. He's got room past the 30. And he's going to be out up around the 45-yard line. Gain of 25 yards.
I like watching the wide receiver screen because it's a real teamwork play. Because guess what? The guy catching the ball, he'll get all the credit. But how about the people up to block in front of him, either fellow receivers or offensive linemen? That makes that play a really nice timing play, and sometimes it can break big.
That'll be incomplete with 9 seconds now showing on the clock.
Well, a momentary speed bump there with that throw, partner. The defense had other ideas, and they're trying to mount a small stand before this drive reaches the end zone.
Watson looks to throw again. He's got Akins, the tight end. And this offense going to elect to burn a timeout with 5 seconds remaining in quarter number two. Now with 5 seconds left, not really enough time to run another play and then stop it. So on comes the field goal unit.
York able to send this one through,
and that will extend their lead even further. So a big play before the end of the half to get them into this spot, and they cash in with three.
How about the 1-2 to the solar plexus on that one? The big play, the field goal, not much time left on the clock. That's the way to go into the half.
And not wanting to risk anything here late in the half, we'll just take a knee, and they'll bring the football out to the 25. The Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive. 1 second, all that remains. A final shot before the break. Fields eluding the pressure right. And they'll get this well past midfield before being stopped just before the 35. That's it for the first half. Two more quarters to go. We'll have plenty more to see after the break. Welcome back. Charles and I settled into the booth ready for quarter number three. 10-0 is our score as we get started again on EA Sports. And the half will begin with a touchback. The Pittsburgh offense at the line to start their next drive. In the first half, they struggled a little bit to keep pace offensively, CD, down 2 scores here. So how do they make some changes coming out of the locker room?
Well, they've studied what they did in the first half. They've seen what the defense has thrown at them. Now they want to have a plan of attack against it. So you come out, you're not going to get all the points back on one drive. But get started on it. Start chopping into that lead, and maybe it'll inspire your defense to help out as well.
Ball on the 36 now. Here's a 2nd and 4.
A run with Harris out of the shotgun. Gets around him.
And some good acceleration there as he's across midfield to the 48-yard line.
Pittsburgh getting 16 yards there and also a first down.
Sometimes it's hard to believe, but there are times this game is about patience, isn't it? Has had the game he expected. But that run there, that may get him going.
I was just going to say, maybe that gives him a little juice because you're right, he struggled, especially in that first half.
Yeah, and I know the great ones always think to themselves, just hang in there. I'm just one big carry away from busting this open. That's a good start for him.
That one good for 20 on the catch and run. I don't know what they talked about at halftime. Whatever it was, it worked. They look like a different team here in the third quarter.
Yeah, I doubt that there are very many trash cans that got kicked over that type of a speech. I think what they did was they analyzed what worked in the first half, what didn't, and figured out a better game plan.
Yeah, he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. 2nd and right at a yard.
That play wasn't quite as big as the play that preceded it, but still. Gotta like the way they're moving the football, partner.
Absolutely. Pretty good room to run on that last play.
Yeah, they didn't get a first down, but still, you take runs like that each and every time, won't you?
And holding it may be the wrong decision as he stopped in the backfield. It's a loss of 4. Now 3rd down.
Well, I would have figured after the 9-yard run on the previous play, getting one more yard wouldn't have been much of a problem. But apparently it was. And now it's 3rd down.
And that That's going to be incomplete. The coverage too good there. The contact popped the ball free, and it's fourth down.
You get the sense that they're saying, we're not playing up to what we're capable of, and we're deep enough into the game that the early jitters are long gone, that they should now have some sense of continuity and be able to make some of these plays that they have not been doing so far.
So they were facing the deficit coming out of the locker room at intermission, and at least they're able to get the field goal to cut into that deficit.
Yeah, now your offense feels pretty good about itself, right? A little bit more up to speed coming out of the break. You turn to your defense now and say, hey, we got three there. We're chipping into the lead. Can you help us out? Hold them. Let's get the ball back for us.
The Cleveland offense ready to go. Their defense has done the job. Now it's the offense's turn as they've got it first and 10. They begin this drive with Chubb to about the 35, second down. In the first half, he was held in check on the ground, but despite that lack of production, they still have the lead.
Yeah, and they've got to feel fortunate about that. If they could actually get production from their lead horse, that would help open up this offense and widen this margin, too.
From the 35, here's a second and 7.
Here's Watson. They set up the screen to Chubb. Give him 3 on the screen. He couldn't break free, and it's third down.
Good reactions there defensively. That screen was a little slow in developing, and they shut that one down with little gain.
In search of 4 yards here to pick up the first down.
Watson now to throw. He's going to get that to his running back out of the backfield. And he's going to have the Browns first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
Well, they certainly had success throughout this contest getting him the ball in the passing game. And there he picks up another first down. Whatever they saw going into this one, they've been able to capitalize on it. And no adjustment has been made to take it away.
To the left side and complete for Amari Cooper. He's to the 15. And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Cleveland. Amari Cooper, 53 yards.
And the Browns have taken a 2-touchdown lead now. Extra point by York is up and good.
And the lead is now 17-3. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away.
And the returner down to a knee, and this will come out to the 30-yard line.
The Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive. And after the field goal last time, we'll see what they can get here. At least they got points out of the last drive, Charles.
I never met an offensive coach that didn't want a drive to end with a kick. Most of them wanted to end with a PAT, right? In this case, a field goal, they'll take it way better than the alternative, which is a punt.
Yeah, but you've met fan bases that wanted that, that weren't happy with that field goal.
I haven't met a fan base yet that wants a drive to end with a kick, other than the extra point. That's it.
Caught. It's Wilson. Down the sideline he goes. Inside the 10. And into the end zone. Touchdown, Pittsburgh. A big play there. 61 yards.
And the Steelers have got it back to within a score.
As a former DB, you might not like to see that, but from a wide receiver's perspective, those are the plays they dream of.
Correct on both counts, all right? Because once he took off, I mean, let's face it, that should have been done in Big Sky Country. Aren't any speed limits out there? And off he went. Glad I wasn't the one trying to chase him.
This game back within a touchdown now as the kickoff's away.
Hey,
A lane opens here. He's past the 30. The Browns drive about to get started. And their lead cut in half by that touchdown a moment ago. They are up 7 as they begin this drive, 1st and 10. And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. 2nd and right at a yard.
Hitting out a ton of success here so far, but you get the feeling that he might be on the verge of popping one.
Yeah, even on that one, there was a little bit of a hole, but it closed there quickly at the end.
Second down, here's Chubb again.
And he'll be brought down right at the 45-yard line.
2nd and 1, and people want to run the football. This is where every back in the league is supposed to do exactly what we just saw there, pick up the first down.
To about the 48-yard line.
We know that old expression, it's not my night. It hasn't been his so far. I don't know if the legs are a little bit heavy. Sometimes having to hang out all day and play doesn't exactly play to your advantage, but it's been a tough go for him.
And every time he looks up, somebody's there defensively. That was the same case on that play.
From the 48-yard line, here's 2nd down at 7.
They'll try the air now with Watson. That's complete to the tight end, Akins. And he got blown up. Losing yardage on the play back at the 44. So that'll go as a 4-yard loss on the play. And that brings up 3rd and a full 10 yards.
Now right where this set of downs started, they need a full 10 here to pick up the first down and move the chains.
From the gun on 3rd down, Watson. Work in the middle of the field, and he's got a man complete. And they're going to have themselves another 1st down as the tackle's made at the Steelers' 43. And we're back now here in Cleveland. It's the Browns football, and they've got the lead here as we start quarter number 4. Down run, he gets maybe 3.
I like a guy who understands the situation. I also like a guy who you look at him and you say, that looks like a guy who knows the coach is going to say, guess what? You drop this one, you'll be carrying around the training facility for an entire week.
Maybe flashback to high school or college, carrying it around campus, right?
The old gauntlet drill, right? Anyone get the ball out while he's sitting in class and bring it back to the coach? He's in big trouble.
How good has he been throwing the football, though? And despite that incompletion, that's just the 3rd time he's been off target this entire game.
And Brandon, I've been on the other side of this equation, trying to defend a guy who's been this hot, and it chips away at your confidence. And when you're not confident when you're trying to defend, it makes you slower to the football, and it leads to more completions for them.
The Browns on 3rd down. They've been very good, 5 for 7 thus far. This is 3rd and 7. From the gun, it's a give to Chubb. And they went the wrong way there. Losing yardage back at the 43-yard line. 4th down now after a loss of 2.
When coaches stress their defense being physical, they don't just mean the big guys. How about the guys on the outside, the cornerbacks? It's not just their job to patrol the airspace. They can get involved in the run game as well.
On 4th down, the punt team is on as this is sent away. And this ball is going to be down now right at the 10-yard line. Good spot. And for an offense that is struggling, this is not where you want to start from. Great punt.
Fantastic punt. And for all those who wonder, what do punters do during the course of practice each and every day? The best ones do what we just saw there. Work on positioning the football and helping their team.
Now Fields. A short one there to Freiermuth.
Short completion, just 4 yards, and that'll bring up second down. One thing I think that's safe to say defensively, the tackling's been really good.
And because of that, it's been very, very hard for them to move the ball because you're not getting the benefits of run after catch. You're tackling them almost on the spot. That means you have to run extra plays, harder to move it.
Fields now to throw. And this one incomplete, threw it down at the feet of his receiver.
Well, that's where this Cleveland crowd, the dog pound in particular, make it difficult on opposing offenses. It looked like they might have had troubles communicating at the line, and it leads to the incompletion.
So after the second down incompletion, they'll come up now against a 3rd and 6. Now the Browns will use the first of their 3 timeouts. That'll leave them with 2 remaining. We'll be back after this. An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on 3rd down. Third down, here's Patterson. And he'll lose yardage here. Back at the 11, he goes down. And a loss of 3 to bring up 4.
Sometimes I think these defensive tackles get a little bit of a bum rap. We just see them as big guys that eat up blockers for others to make tackles. Oftentimes they're quicker than they get credit for. And this time he uses quickness to make a play.
And he'll take it on this side of midfield. And he's able to take it across midfield before going out of bounds. Call it an even 40-yard punt, 7, though, on the return. And the Browns have a short field in front of them now as they take over 1st and 10. Now it's Watson. Going out wide, finds Chubb. And he'll take it down shy of the 45 at the 46.
Well, offensively, that's the mismatch that you want. You want to force a linebacker to try and cover your back out of the backfield, out in some open space. But linebackers nowadays, they run like backs, and they take a lot of pride in covering. What a nice play he made there in the open field.
Watson, a little touch pass on the jet sweep. And that one not fooling anyone. It'll go down as a completed pass, but it will lose a big chunk of yardage.
Well, I think the hope is, you know, with a touch pass like that, maybe you catch the defense off guard, but they were all over that one.
And it is the kind of play that works better against certain defenses, and this clearly was the wrong one to run into. Really nice job getting him down behind the line of scrimmage.
Possibly a turning point. Big play coming. This is 3rd and long. From the 50, it's Watson. A hit as he throws there, incomplete.
Well, that's a good piece of quarterbacking right there because he certainly felt the pressure coming. The alternative, getting sacked for the first time. He didn't like that option at all. Did a nice job saving yardage by throwing that one away.
So they're forced to punt on 4th as this one's away. Bust through the tackle. That'll go as a punt of 32 yards. And it will be 1st and 10 as they take over. The Pittsburgh offense at the line to start their next drive.
These guys definitely hoping for a better showing than their last appearance. They couldn't really even move the football much beyond the shadows of their own goalpost, Charles. We'll see if they can get a better, more sustained drive going here.
Yeah, and every team that we ever talk to says the exact same thing. When you start a drive from that deep in your own territory, the goal is a minimum of at least 2 first downs. Because even if you have to punt then, you change the field position, right? You flip the field a little bit. They didn't get that done. This time they want to string together a nice drive and help themselves out.
On the give, this is Harris. And he's able to get out to the 32, brought down there.
2nd and 1 is often an invitation to take the big shot downfield. I bet the offensive lineman said, are you kidding? We just get on our backs and let's go get the first down. They love being physical.
All 3 timeouts plus the 2-minute warning. Here's 1st and 10. Fields tapping it forward, jet sweep.
And past the 40 before he's out of bounds. Now second down in a few inches. Now a give, running left is Harris. Shreds the tackle, and he'll be brought down just shy of midfield at the 49-yard line. We've got a one-score game with inside of 2 minutes remaining. This is first and 10. Back to throw, Fields. He's got his tight end Freiermuth over the middle. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20.
Ah, yes, down by a touchdown. They needed a big play here quickly, and they got one. And now, plenty of time. No need to panic, but you do need to move quickly.
Plenty of time. All three timeouts still remain. Here's first and 10 now. Can't get a throw off. He's taken down. What a huge play at this point in the game. Finally hauled down for the first time this game. Multiple defenders in there to drop him. They'll come up now. This is second and long. Now Fields. Oh, no, he lost the football. And now this ball picked up by the offense. But here in the final 2 minutes of the game, this will be blown dead. Only the fumbler can advance the football. So this will go back to the spot of the fumble itself. The towels are waving. Steeler fans on their feet. It's third down. Trying to pick it up on the ground with Harris. And he has the first down before he's tackled at the 5.
I think they like this drive a little bit better there, partner. Running game helping out, picking up some of the slack. Because remember the last drive, they went 3 and out.
Here we go. First and goal. Fields going to toss this quickly out wide, complete.
I'm a little surprised right here. They've got 3 timeouts left. The clock's running down, and they aren't using them. Those timeouts do you no good at home. Use them now.
He's into the end zone, so they get the late score they needed, and now the extra point can tie this thing up in the final minute.
And while it appears the heavy lifting was accomplished by scoring the touchdown, they're still down one. That extra point is not a gimme.
Don't forget the extra point. It's up and good. And, partner, we've got a tie game here in the fourth. This one, all we could have asked for. All tied, final minute as the kick's away here. And they'll start this drive just across the 30. Pretty nice work on the return. Here's first and 10. To throw, Watson. And he can't get a throw away. He's taken down. Now the Steelers use the first of their 3 timeouts as they stop it with 22 ticks to go in the fourth. They'll come up now on second down. Watson to throw.
And he'll give a first down up past the 40 as the clock ticks on. Remember, the one timeout still available as they come up first and 10. Here's Watson. Under pressure now, Watson, and down he goes. The former Buckeye, Cameron Hayward, in there for sack number 85 of his great career, moving him past Hall of Famer Howie Long on the all-time list.
It's a little teaching moment here. Overtime rules. Remind us how this goes, partner.
Okay, so in the past, we had sudden death. First team to score wins, but no longer. Now, if the team receives the ball, scores a touchdown, they win the game. If they kick a field goal, though, or don't score, the other team gets a possession. And after both teams get a possession, then we're into sudden death. First team to score wins the game.
And they will wrangle him down a couple yards shy of the 30. The Cleveland offense ready to go.
All set up for him right now, Charles. Opening possession of overtime. They've got the football. They also obviously have this home crowd behind him in a big way.
They get that extra energy from them, but they've got to be careful not to let that adrenaline get away from them and play too fast or create errors of their own making. Use that energy, embrace it, but make sure they channel it the right way. They've got a chance to go downfield, score a touchdown, and end this game.
On first down, they'll run with Chubb. And he's going to take this ahead for right around 3 yards, but no more than that. Second down.
Not a huge carry there on first down, but not all of them will be. But still, all in all, a positive play for the offense. It's all about picking up at least a few to set up what you're going to do here on second down.
We'll play only the one overtime here. If time runs out, it'll be a tie as they come up on second down. To throw is Watson. He's got the connection to Cooper. And just 3 yards on the catch there. He couldn't get away. And now we've got a third and 4.
And we've seen him have success earlier on with the ball in his hands because he has a get it in space and make a play kind of a receiver. But that time, they closed on him quickly and held him to a short game.
It's 3rd and 4. Big play here. Try to keep this opening drive of overtime alive. Now Watson. And he gets it to his running back, Nick Chubb. And he won't get close. Only a yard. 4th and 3.
How about that strategy there, Brandon? 3rd down. They just said, we've got faith in our tacklers. We'll give you the short stuff. And just decided to protect the sticks. So every time I hear fans telling me tackling's not a part of the game anymore, plays like that, I can clip and save and show them you have to tackle well if you want to be a good defense.
A big call here in overtime. They're going for it on 4th down. And before this 4th and 3 play, we're going to get whistles and a timeout. They'll be left with just one remaining here at OT. So a big move here, playing to win in overtime. They're going to go for it on 4th down. They will indeed snap it to Watson. And he's brought down. Can't do anything with a football. It's a sack and a turnover on downs. The Browns unable to move the chains on 4th down. And this Steeler defense able to come up with a stop. The Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive.
But their defense did the job, got off the field without giving up any points. And now, Charles, all they need here is a field goal and they get the victory.
Yeah, and this is the way I love overtime. I'm one of those really, really old school guys that like sudden death right from the beginning. But we've got it now because any points wins the game. On defense, get a safety, a pick six, fumble return. You can win it as well. So I'm really looking forward to this series and see how both sides play it.
On a determined run there as he's going to take this all the way down near the 40. Carry for Harris. And this time they were waiting for him as he'll be knocked down before he can get back to the line of scrimmage.
An interesting and intriguing decision there defensively because they kept extra DBs on the field despite seeing the multiple tight end look that came out for the offense.
I thought they were going to switch out of it. I didn't know if they felt they didn't have time or what the case was.
Well, in any event, the extra speed allowed for great penetration as they stuffed that one behind the line of scrimmage.
Down inside the 10, and he is in for the score! And it is absolute stunned silence here as they win it on the road in overtime. As the fans exit back out through the turnstiles, not happy looks on their faces. Feel like they probably let this one slip away at home in overtime.
I would agree with that, and their unhappiness hurts the guys in the concession stands on the way out, right? Not stopping to buy something for the kids. They just want to get home. But what a dramatic way to finish this bad boy off. I mean, this game was dramatic all the way through. That's why we got to overtime. And then to go ahead and finish it this way, the fans screaming out unhappy, but the team that came in here and won this one on the road, they sprinted to their locker room.
And speaking of buying things, dinner on you tonight, Davis.
I kind of figured that was coming.